From Best Bud origin stories being completely switched up on the fly, to massive logic gaps in some of the biggest shows ever to grace a screen, these infuriating plot holes left a bitter taste in even the most passionate fan's mouth. I'm Gareth from WhatCulture.com, and here are the 10 most annoying TV plot holes ever. Number 10, Phoebe's dad ran out on her before she was born, but somehow sang her lullabies. Friends. The character of Phoebe Buffay didn't have what you class as the most idyllic upbringing. On top of her stepfather going to prison and her mother committing suicide when she was young, the eccentric member of everyone's favourite friendship group was abandoned by her father before she was even born. Or at least that's what we were told early into Friends' run on NBC. However, by the time we get to season 5, Phoebe comes face to face with her biological father and things get a little bit confusing. Frank Buffay Sr. explains to Phoebe that he was a terrible father. He burned baby formula, couldn't put their nappies on right, and would often make them cry when singing his rather familiar made-up lullaby, Sleepy Girl. All this points to a father who was most definitely around his twin daughters for a while before deciding he wasn't cut out for the job. In fairness to Phoebe, she did wind up homeless at 14, and contracted hepatitis after a pimp spit in her mouth. So you can probably forgive her for getting her wires crossed when it came to recalling exactly when Daddy did a runner. Number 9, the employees were well aware of being filmed constantly, but were still shocked. The Office. Throughout the series' 9-season run on NBC, the American version of The Office saw the eclectic employees of Dunder Mifflin quite clearly having their every move, coffee break, and love affair documented by a dedicated group of filmmakers. So that's what made the decision to have the characters lose their minds upon realizing that quite literally everything that went down within the Scranton walls had been immortalized, whilst watching back parts of the doc during the last season, such a difficult pill to swallow. Time and time again, the likes of Pam, Jim, Dwight, and the gang were all too happy to reveal rather personal information to the ever-present camera over the course of the show. Then, just like that, that openness was quickly forgotten in order to stir up some last-ditch drama in the closing stages. Number 8, so many elevator inconsistencies. The Big Bang Theory. From the very first episode of the eventual comedy juggernaut that became The Big Bang Theory, audiences were made well aware of the fact that the elevator in Leonard, Sheldon, and Penny's building was well and truly buggered. 14 episodes in, Leonard then goes out of his way to inform his pal Howard that said elevator has been out of commission for 2 whole years. As he attempted to fix it in 2008. However, a few seasons down the road, Leonard later recounts the tale of how this trusty contraption met its broken fate to Penny, and a few things simply don't add up. First of all, during the story of how the elevator broke, Howard was very much present when Leonard's rocket explosion ultimately destroyed it from the inside, meaning that he knew very well that it wasn't working in that earlier season 1 episode, and his attempts to figure out what was wrong with it look a bit odd in hindsight. Also, during the recalling of how the machine ended up out of order, Leonard told Penny the lift broke in 2003, going back on his earlier comment of it being broken in 2006. Best to just forget about it and take the stairs, eh? Number 7, why does a fighting game have a sex function? Black Mirror. Sometimes a plot hole is completely unavoidable when it comes to realizing a, let's say, more out there concept on the small screen. In the case of Black Mirror's compelling video game-centric first episode of its 5th season, Striking Vipers, creator Charlie Brooker was very much aware a few things didn't add up. He was just hoping you'd overlook these details by the time the story had you well and truly gripped. The plot hole in question reveals itself in the story's core, as two friends immerse themselves in a fighting game that allows them to feel every physical sensation their avatar does in the combat environment. Things take a turn as the two go on to spark up a virtual sexual relationship through this pastime. But why was the option to allow the player to experience sexual sensations ever included in a fighting game in the first place? Brooker himself admitted that the show attempted to gloss over this odd decision, telling Radio Times, "In the end, we thought we won't focus on that, no one's gonna mention it. We were wrong." Yes, yes you were. Number 6, JD and Turk's ever-changing origin story, Scrubs. Though smash hit medical comedy Scrubs boasted a whole host of memorable recurring characters, it's hard to look past the dynamic duo of John Dorian and Christopher Turk as the very foundation of the series. The pair's zany friendship offers up routinely side-splitting antics and equally heartwarming beats from start to finish. Yet it is in those humble beginnings where things started to get a bit muddled as the show unfolded. Season 2 saw JD appear at the 2's dorm for the first time in a flashback, as the goofball radiated his glorious dorkiness from day one. However, Season 4 would later see an alternate first meet between the two play out, as Turk wandered into the pair's dorm to find JD decked in a wizard's hat in front of his computer. For such a close and meaningful friendship, it seems odd that the pair seem to possess wildly inconsistent memories of their initial encounter. Yet it's more likely that the showrunners just couldn't resist another gag at the wizard in training that was a young Mr. Dorian's expense. Continuity be damned! Number 5, Danielle Rousseau doesn't remember the man who stole her baby. Lost. By the time J.J. Abrams' Lost finally rode off into the sunset in 2010, the show had become as known for its balmy twists as it was for choosing to completely ignore vital plot points. One of the most notable instances of this happening came in the form of one Danielle Rousseau, the crazy Frenchwoman, forgetting something that acts as her entire motivation. After trying to steal Claire's baby and capturing Saeed, it's later revealed that Rousseau's daughter was actually kidnapped by Ben Linus and the others. We find this out when the gang go back in time, adding another plot hole as future Rousseau would clearly recognize people from her own past in those earlier seasons. But when she comes face to face with Linus again in the present, Danielle doesn't recognize him as the man who stole her baby all those years ago. You could point to the fact that Rousseau is routinely referenced as having gone a little crazy during her years on the island as a reason for this failure to acknowledge her child's captor there and then. But it was more likely just a consequence of Michael Emerson being too good to write off after his early impressive displays on the show as Gale slash Linus. Number 4, Marshall's close family no-show his wedding, How I Met Your Mother. Fairly early into CBS's tale of Ted Mosby explaining to his kids precisely how he met their mother, the show makes a point of showing just how close Marshall is to the rest of the Erickson clan in Minnesota. Growing up, Marshall would playfully scrap with his brothers under no-holds-barred rules, and would call his dad daily no matter how many years went by. So when it came time for Lily and Marshall to tie the knot at the end of Season 2, you'd be forgiven for assuming his tight-knit family would want to be in attendance for such an important moment in his life. In the end though, not a single Erickson could be spotted on the day Marshall gave himself an unfortunate trim, and got married to the love of his life, no less. The majority of Lily's family no-showed too, it must be said. Yet those absences went under the radar when put up against Marshall's joint-at-the-hip brothers and parents deciding to give the special occasion a miss. Number 3, Claire's healing power origin isn't consistent. Heroes. It's established in the pilot episode of Heroes that Claire Bennett only discovers her miraculous ability to heal rapidly as she hits puberty, smashing her hand in a glass case only to reveal no scarring or wounds upon undoing her bandages down the line. Yet after a later scene alongside her biological mother, that early discovery suddenly seems to possess a few holes. Claire's mother confesses to her that she assumed her child had died in a house fire when she was a baby, even telling her, "You were dead," and admitting that the fact she somehow survived was a miracle. Claire possessing this ability to heal at a superhuman level at such a young age, and then simply losing it up until the point she hit 15 years old, seems like a bit of a stretch. So it's more likely that the writers just thought this was a neat way to explain how the pair were separated so early into Claire's life, and hoped you'd forget about those years of not knowing slash using her gifts shortly after. Number 2, Jake can't grow a beard, but grows one anyway. Brooklyn Nine-Nine. Brooklyn Nine-Nine's resident loose cannon detective, Jake Peralta, is a man of many talents. If you're looking for a sweetly timed innuendo, a bottomless pit of die-hard knowledge, or even the name of absolutely every Transformer known to man, then look no further. However, one skill the emotionally stunted cop sadly doesn't possess is the ability to grow facial hair. In fact, he even goes on record to state that he is physically incapable. Yet, as we eventually found out in Season 5 of the Comedy Police procedural, Peralta may not know his face as well as he thinks he does. As Jake spends some time in the slammer after himself and Rosa Diaz are framed for a bank robbery, we see a very distinct lack of an inability to grow a mustache. Jake actually boasts a rather full and rugged beard a couple months into his sentence, proving that he did in fact have it in him all along. Or perhaps the showrunners just chose to ignore the stream of nonsense that had tumbled out of his mouth in the years before, and decided that a beard was the best way of showing time passing in the can. Number 1. White Walkers can't swim until they need to. Game of Thrones. The ominous force that were the White Walkers at times felt like a threat that seemingly could not be overcome. Should you somehow find a way to cut them down, the Night King would simply raise your own dead back to life and carry on whooping your ass. Thankfully though, the creepy whites have something of an Achilles heel in the form of not being able to doggy paddle across oceans. Or any body of water for that matter. As Jon Snow stoically put it himself when asked, "Can they swim?" by Euron Greyjoy? No. Yet that does leave us with one rather gaping plot hole in the penultimate episode of Season 7. Here we see a fairly large dead dragon be hauled out of freezing waters beyond the wall by those very same whites. But how could they achieve such a feat without performing some very intricate tying and locking methods underwater? In short, they surely couldn't. Which means either Mr. Snow is talking out of his Targaryen a-hole, or the showrunners simply opted to ignore all logic in order to reanimate a fire-breathing monster. And we can't really blame them if that was the case. And that's our list. Know of any other annoying TV plot holes we missed? Let us know all about them in the comments section right down below, and do not forget to like, share, and click on that subscribe button. Also, be sure to head on over to whatculture.com and find some more incredible articles just like the one this video you are watching is based on. I've been Gareth from whatculture.com. Thank you for clicking on this video today, and I'm sure I'll see you very, very soon. Bye-bye!